Lord, yes, yes, Lord, amen. I'm trading my sorrows, I'm trading my shame, I'm laying them down for the joy of the Lord. I'm trading my sickness, I'm trading my pain, I'm laying them down for the joy of the Lord. And we say, yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, yes, Lord, amen. And we say, yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, yes, Lord, amen.
Good morning and welcome to the virtual service for Luther Rice Memorial Baptist Church in Silver Spring, Maryland for Sunday, October 18th, 2020. A big welcome to all on the phone lines and on various social media platforms. We know you have a choice of where to worship on Sunday morning, and we are so glad you have chosen to be with us this morning. Don't forget, immediately following today's service, we will have our quarterly church business meeting. As you experience today's service, please feel free to use the chat or comment box to communicate to us all. And now, let us prepare our hearts and minds for today's worship.
Welcome this morning to Luther Rice Memorial Baptist Church. My name is the Reverend Alicia Langhorne, and I have the privilege of serving as the interim pastor during this season in the life of this great body of God. We are so grateful that you chose to worship with us this morning. We're so grateful that you're watching us on YouTube, Facebook, or Zoom. We invite you, if you're on Facebook or YouTube, to share this message, like us, start a watch party. You will never know how the Word of God will transform someone's life until you offer it to them. We want to give God thanks this morning. I want to announce that Luther Rice is stronger. God is working through us in ways we couldn't even imagine. We received another grant. This grant is from the District of Columbia Baptist Convention. We received a grant to help bridge the gap between seniors and technology. They don't even know that our seniors here at Luther Rice have already led the way. They're already learning. They have been for the last 8 months using Zoom, learning about Facebook, all kinds of things. It's now time for us to take our message to the world. More details will be forthcoming, but I invite you to offer up thanks to God for blessing Luther Rice in this special way and pray for our direction that we be good and faithful stewards to the work that God has put in our hands. Luther Rice strong. Praise the Lord. We also thank you in advance for all of our volunteers for the food pantry. Hopefully by now you've received electronic sign-up sheet for volunteers. If you know someone, please send it. We want to make sure that many hands will make light work of the work that God has put in front of us. Please don't forget, we have 2 more weeks of our Light It Up campaign to light up and beautify our sanctuary. We thank God for everyone that's already given. You can give again. We are in this season of pandemic. We are making sure to take care of the house of God that God has provided for us. One of those things is to make sure we can see when we come back into the sanctuary. So help us by making some donation that speaks from your heart and sowing some seed into Luther Rice for our Light It Up campaign as we seek to move out of the sanctuary and light up the world with the Word of God. I want to give thanks to everyone who attended our Seeing Difference Differently Diversity Workshop. And for those of you who missed it, I just want to let you know we've only just begun. That was the beginning because we are people who are committed to putting our faith in action as we rebuild from the inside out. And finally, I want to thank everyone for the pastoral appreciation gift. I have to tell you, it was just the right size. It was just my taste. And for those of you who don't know, the church, in honor of pastoral appreciation month, gifted me a meal service for 2 weeks, or 14 meals, so I guess it's 1 week, has gifted me meals prepared by someone else's hand. Y'all know I like to eat, so I'm very grateful. It was the perfect gift. I appreciated all the calls, all the cards, and know there are still some more days left in the month if you haven't gotten yours in yet. But I love you, Lutherites. And as I said before, I am so honored and grateful to God and to all of you that at this season in my own life, God would have me serving alongside with all of you. I love you and appreciate you. So don't forget, it is now time for worship. So thank you again for worshiping this morning. Let us lift up the holy name of God.
Good morning. October is the beginning of the fall season. It is also Pastor Alicia's birthday, but it is also Pastor Appreciation Month. I remember receiving a call one Saturday morning in May. Pastor John had passed. One of my first thoughts was to try to preach. It seemed too late to get a substitute, but I thought maybe Pastor Alicia could help. She had filled in before, so I called her. Though she was shocked, she took a minute. She said, okay, the rest is history. Though she had her own grief, she stepped up. She and Luther Rice already had a bond. As we said goodbye that day, she told me, I'm here as long as you need me. Since that Sunday, she has stepped up continually. She has taken on much more than many interns, from working with 5 churches to 2 schools, food, drives, counseling, to being a friend and comfort to others. She has said she felt the calling. As it became clear that everything was changing due to Corona-19, she has constantly led us to learn and reach further. She has also led to better understanding of the racial issues facing us all. While many groups have suffered from fear and uncertainty, she has inspired and calmed us. We are not many in numbers, but her support and commitment have led the way to bigger things. Pastor Alicia, we love, appreciate, and honor you for your love and commitment. Sincerely, the Congregation of Luther Rice. P.S. Please call during her office hours or write a notice and let her know how you feel before the end of October. Thank you.
Church announcements. Today, immediately following church service, we will have our quarterly church business meeting. This week, we will have pastor's office hours on Monday, October 19th from 4 to 6 p.m. The pandemic media team will meet on Monday, October 19th at 6:30 p.m. The trustees will convene on Wednesday, October 21st at 6 p.m. And we will end the week with our weekly session of Chat and Chew on Friday, October 23rd at 12 o'clock noon. Don't forget, Luther Rice is looking for people to serve as readers, singers, and to participate in our virtual worship. If interested in helping, please reach out to the church office or to Pastor Alicia. Our October theme of the month is More Than Conquerors. Building on our theme from last month of Be the Change, let us now focus on how to put our faith ahead of our fears and the trials that will come as a result of putting our faith into action. As Pastor Alicia previously mentioned, Luther Rice has been blessed with a sizable grant from the Capital Area Food Bank. With this grant, we will be able to significantly increase our weekly food distribution. We are so thankful for this blessing, but we need your help. As the saying goes, many hands makes for light work. So if you're able to help with our upcoming food distributions and food packing, please use the electronic sign-up form, which can be found in the chat box or the comment box. Please reach out to the church office for additional information and for sign-up. Looking for further connection with Luther Rice Memorial Baptist Church? We invite you to use the virtual connection and prayer request card. All links can be found in the chat box on Zoom and on our Facebook and YouTube page. Need information on any of these church activities? Please call or email the church office at 301-593-1130 or email lutherrice@aol.com.
Good morning again. I invite you to join me in today's call to worship. The words will appear on the screen. I'll read where it says pastor. I invite you to join in where it says people. If God is for us, who is against us?
God, who gave us God's Son, now gives us the Spirit and power.
The Holy One is in our midst,
equipping us for life in the service of Christ.
In Christ, we are more than conquerors.
For nothing in creation can separate us from the love of God.
May the all-surpassing grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you.
And the unshakable love of God be with you.
And the joyous communion of the Holy Spirit with you, together
and also with you.
Let us pray. Gracious and almighty God, we usher in your Holy Spirit. We ask you to make ready hearts, make ready minds, make ready spirits for you to dwell and make your home. God, we thank you for another Sunday morning's rising, another day to worship you. Touch every mind, touch every spirit, touch every part of every being of all those who gather to worship this morning. In Jesus' name, amen.
This is Priscilla Soto, and I'll be singing Jacob's Ladder.
Jacob's Ladder,
We thank you for your continued giving and support of our church and ministries. For our virtual service, we have several ways you can give electronically to the church. Giving via PayPal, we have a new fee-free way to give. Open up your PayPal account, select send and receive, and then enter the following email address, treasurer@lutherricechurch.org. When you select how you want to pay, look below and make sure it says sending to a friend. Using the Cash App, look for us at $LutherRice Memorial. Continue to look for the steeple on both electronic services to confirm you are in the right place. And as always, you are also welcome to mail your offering to the church office at 801 University Boulevard West, Silver Spring, Maryland, 20901.
Please pray with me. Father, we come today with our blessings and our gifts. May our gifts be a betterment to your community in order to reach as many as possible. Watch over us, take care of us, and help us to give generously. In Christ we pray, amen.
Join me for a moment of prayer. There is always much to pray about, many to pray for, and if you, like me, some weeks are more challenging than others. The word says the Spirit intercedes with utterings and groans, with sighs too deep for words. Though we know that all things work together for those who love God, we still go to God in prayer, because it's our time to pour out our hearts before the Master. Let us pray. God of heaven and earth and everything in between, we come humbly before you, thanking you for another opportunity to come to you with our prayers, with our cries, with our sighs that only the Spirit can identify. God, we come this morning, some of us bowed down and heavy laden, some of us tired of just going through the daily trials and tribulations of everyday life, of bills, of sickness, of worry. God, we come this morning to your altar because we know, we've read, we've heard, we believe that at your altar is a safe place to leave our burdens. Some of us carry the burden of grief. Some of us of sorrow, of depression. Some of us of guilt for things that we've left undone and things that we've done wrong. God, we come in this moment because we believe at your altar we find relief. At your altar we find comfort. At your mighty altar of prayer, we find the strength to go on yet a while longer. God, thank you for being so forgiving of us. Now, God, help us to be forgiving of those around us, for those that have spoke a word that hurt our hearts, for those that cut us off in traffic, for those that cut us off, we had something meaningful to say. God, we pray that you will help us to not just forgive, but to really be healed from the hurt, the harm, and the danger that comes in so many different ways. God, we pray for those of our Luther Rice body who are sick. We pray for those who are sick in the world whose names we don't know to call. We pray for every person now that has lost, that is fighting against COVID right now. We thank you for those who are healed, God, but we pray for even greater healing. We pray for those who are in hospital beds this morning. Send some extra angels to every hospital bed. Remind the people who are there that you are with them. We pray for families this morning, for families who, though they love each other, are struggling right now to understand. each other, that are struggling to stay together in this moment. God, we pray that you would be a healer, that you will allow peace to flow like rivers and homes. We pray for our young people, the young people here in the United States and the young people all across the country. God, because we know that they are watching us right now. God, help them to see and be able to point out those things that are wrong and evil so that they can have so they can make a better world. God, where we have failed, where we have not done all that you've asked us to do, we ask you to raise up young people who will stand not just in the gap, but will lead us along the way. God, we worship you. We thank you for the privilege of praying. We thank you for hearing, for answering. God, we thank you for making our prayer straight where we went left and we should have went right. God, we just love you. We worship you and adore you. In the mighty and matchless name of Jesus Christ, we together say amen.
My name is Javelle Fayette, and I'll be reading Judges chapter 6, verse 11 through 18. The angel of the Lord came and sat under the oak in Ophrah that belonged to Josiah the Abiezrite, where his son Gideon was thressing wheat in a winepress to keep it from the Midianites. When the angel of the Lord appeared to Gideon, he said, "The Lord is with you, mighty warrior." "Pardon me, my lord," Gideon replied, "but if the Lord is with us, why has all this happened to us? Where are all his wonders that our ancestors told us about when they said, 'Did not the Lord bring us out of Egypt?' But now the Lord has abandoned us and given us into the hand of Midian." The Lord turned to him and said, "Go in the strength you have and save Israel out of Midian's hand. Am I not sending you?" "Pardon me, my lord," Gideon replied, "but how can I save Israel? My clan is the weakest in Messiah, and I am the least in my family." The Lord answered, "I will be with you, and you will strike down all the Midianites, leaving none alive." Gideon replied, "If now I have found favor in your eyes, give me a sign that it is really you talking to me. Please do not go away until I come back and bring my offering and set it before you." And the Lord said, "I will wait until you return."
God will take care of you.
It should come as no surprise after hearing that song that our thought and theme for today is Ease On Down the Road. Let us pray. Almighty and gracious God, we thank you for your word. God, we your people need to hear a word from you. We need to be touched by your spirit and reminded that, Lord, you have a word, you have a will, and you have a way. And we are so blessed that you would want us to be partakers in your will, your way. God, thank you in advance for your word and what it's going to do to and through your people. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, amen. So I don't know how many of you are familiar with that song that preceded this sermon, Ease On Down the Road. It's from the musical The Wiz, which is considered the Black American music version of The Wizard of Oz. Both The Wiz and The Wizard of Oz highlight the reality of what it looks like when we're searching for what's already in us. This sentiment and that fact is carried forth from God to Gideon throughout the mouth of the angel in the text, when the angel says, go in the strength you have. Ever notice how when God sends an angel, when God approaches someone in the Bible, it's never just an ordinary encounter. So here we have Gideon, out seeming like minding his own business, beating the wheat to make the wine. And here comes this angel. And before Gideon can say, why are you here? The angel says, the Lord is with you, you mighty warrior. Who would have thought he would go from beating the wheat to now being a warrior for the Lord? And then the angel says to him, and it's funny, the scripture says, then the Lord turned to him and said, go in the strength you have. This story is the beginning of the Gideon. Most of us, if you've heard about Gideon, you've heard about Gideon and his fleecing. Later on in Judges, there's a story about Gideon praying to God and Gideon saying, Lord, if you're going to be with me, if you're going to help us to meet this, to win this battle, I'll put this fleece on the ground, and you'll make the fleece wet and all the ground around it dry. Then if that wasn't enough, Gideon goes back to God, puts the fleece on the ground, says, God, this time I invite you to make the ground wet, but keep the fleece dry. And both times God answers Gideon. But to go back to the beginning of Gideon's story, we see that God told Gideon at the beginning that Gideon was already a mighty warrior. And I think the same thing happens for all of us. That though God at the beginning of our lives has a plan, has a purpose for us, that even as we're growing up, people often pour into us. You know, we see ourselves do well in some things, but somehow all we can do is hang on to the negative that we've heard, the negative that we've experienced. It starts to become the negative thoughts that we tell ourselves. Look at Gideon. When he says that, he says, but sir, how can I deliver Israel? My clan is the weakest in Manasseh, and I am the least in my family. So Gideon's saying, I know you called me a warrior, but I'm the least of the least. How many of us are we honest and say sometimes we feel like the least of the least? That, you know, I guess the times when we succeed, it's like happenstance. And I feel like even sometimes as a church, we look around at other churches and we say, oh, well, they're so much bigger than us. Oh, they have so much more people than us. Oh, they have so much more money than us. Well, how about instead we remember that when God calls us, God is saying two things to us. God is saying, go. And you're worthy, you're ready for it. So we have to embrace the fact that God has called us, and when God calls us and tells us to go, God is also saying, you have enough just right now for what you need to go. Maybe the problem is we're not willing to go. We want to stay stuck where we are. Too many of us are either stuck in the can't or the don't know. So we say, oh, we can't do that. Oh, I'm not strong enough. Oh, I'm not good with technology. Oh, I'm not good with people. Oh. All these things when all God is saying, go. And God is saying, go, because God is saying, I will be there with you. I'll never leave you nor forsake you, even until the end of time. I don't know why it's so hard for us to fight I can't with the word of God, where God is saying, yeah, I can't, but in you, God, I can. And the other, if we're not stuck in the can't, most of us are stuck in the don't know. I don't know what God wants. I don't know what God wants to do. How about you look at what thing brings you passion? What thing helps you to get excited? What if you could fix it? If you could make it better, you would see the world around you being better. If you've had challenges this summer by thinking, oh, these are great themes and thoughts, be the change, faith in action, but haven't been quite sure of saying, or you've said to yourself or someone else, I just don't know what I'm supposed to do, then this word this morning is for you. Again, this message this morning is simple. Go, because you are enough and you have enough to start. God said it plainly. God says it two or three times in the scripture, just like God says it two or three times to us, that just start. Just take one step in the direction that you want God to call you, that you believe God is calling you, that you hope that God will call you. And remember that God told Gideon, the least of the least, go in the strength you have. There is something down on the inside of each and every one of us that God is just waiting for us to tap into, that God is just waiting for us to believe that God put in us. Don't you know that each and every one of us have the holy breath of God? When God picked up dirt and breathed life to make Adam, that same Holy Ghost life is in each and every one of us. We just have to reach into it, believe in it, and start putting feet to our faith. Now is the time. That is the word for us today. I invite you to do like the words of the song, ease on down the road. If there are things that feel heavy, if there are things that seem to be standing in your way, keep going, keep praying, keep in conversation and dialogue with God. No, we can talk bad about Gideon, but the one thing Gideon did was he kept bringing his low self-esteem, his self-doubt, his feelings of unworthiness right back to the God who called him. Even in this conversation where God says, go with the strength you have, Gideon says, well, I'm the least of the least.
And God, or the angel speaking on behalf of God, says, all right, well, keep doing it. I want you to still keep going. And God is saying the same thing to us today. That no matter how much we doubt ourselves, no matter how much we believe that we aren't enough, God is saying, go in the strength you have. Just start. So the word for today is put one foot in front of the other. Take just one step and see if God will help you along the rest of the way. Let us pray. Gracious and almighty God, we thank you for helping us to begin the journey, taking one step with what you've already placed inside of each and every one of us. God, for those of us who doubt, for those of us who worry, for those of us who fret that we are not enough, God, speak louder than our doubts. Speak louder than our worry. God, allow the past to be behind us and let us look forward to the future with great hope and divine expectation. God, we love you, we worship you, we adore you. In the mighty and matchless name of Jesus Christ. God's people say together, amen. Maybe you need some help easing on down the road. Then now is the time, today is the day, and this is your moment to give your heart, to give your life, to give yourself to Christ. The good news is that while we were yet still sinners, while we weren't thinking about God, God had already sent Jesus Christ to die for each and every one of us. God created us with purpose, with blessing in mind. And so when we decide to give our lives to Christ, all we're saying is, God, we recognize that you created us, that you love us, and we want to say yes. So again, I say, today's the day and now is the time for you to say yes to Christ. If you want to say yes to Christ, if this is your first time, we invite you to let us know on Zoom in the chat box. If you're on Facebook, get into the comments, slide into our DMs. If you're on YouTube, get in the comments. Know that we will reach out to you. We will pray for you. We will pray with you. And if you so desire for us to be your church family, if you want to be a part of Luther Rice Strong, we invite you to come and we will walk with you. We will pray with you. We will love on you. We will let you love on us. We will be the beloved community that God has called us to be. And maybe today, I don't normally give this appeal, but if you're struggling, feeling like you're not enough, feeling like you can't do it when that next task comes along, I invite you to reach out, to let someone know. You can reach out to us here at the church. Our email address is appearing on the bottom of the screen. You can call and ask for prayer. We'll have someone pray with you. You can let us know that you need to be reminded that God created you with purpose in mind. So we love you, we adore you, we thank you, we know that this is your time, this is your moment. Don't delay. Give your life to Christ. morning's benediction, the words will appear on the screen. I'll read where it says leader. I invite you to join in where it says people. With the song of praise on our lips,
we go forth with God.
With the love of God in our hearts,
we go forth with God.
With a commitment to usher in God's kingdom,
we go forth with God.
And with all that we are and all that we can be,
we go forth with God.
May the Lord bless and keep you until we meet again.
Thank you for all who participated in our virtual service today. Again, we know you have a choice of where to be on Sunday morning, and we are so happy that you have chosen to be with us. Now, please stay tuned for our quarterly business meeting.